Looking for the best telescope for astrophotography? In this video, we'll break down the top telescopes available while comparing them for price versus performance. Before we get started with our video detailing the best telescopes for astrophotography on the market, we have included links in the description for each product mentioned, so make sure you check those out to see which one is in your budget range. Starting off at number 1, we have the SkyWatcher Pro ED 80mm APO. My preference for an astrophotography telescope is undoubtedly an apochromatic refractor. This is because in astrophotography, it's even more important to have a telescope that doesn't have any chromatic aberration. My favorite example of this is the SkyWatcher. There's a few reasons why I'd advise the SkyWatcher, especially for beginners. Firstly, the price. It's no secret that with telescopes, you're pretty much going to get your money's worth most of the time. That means if you're going to spend a few thousand dollars, then you can get a better telescope than this one. But that really isn't suitable for beginners. For me, the beginner's mark for astrophotography comes around the $500 mark, give or take a few hundred. You aren't going to get something suitable for astrophotography at 100 or 200 bucks, but if you want a telescope for the kids to play around with, then you can spend 100 bucks and not worry too much. But for taking photos, we need a better telescope, ideally a refractor. Another reason I recommend the 80mm for beginners, as well as it being cheaper, is that you're going to get something much more convenient. In general, 80mm is considered to be an easier to use, get up and go telescope, whereas 120mm versions of the same scope will not have the same ease of use as an 80mm. This telescope works well with the Celestron AVX mount, which is recommended by most as one of the better mounts for beginners. You can also consider building your own mount to save some pennies, which is another good idea for those on a strict budget, but you do need some knowledge. At number 2, we have the Orion ED80T. If you have a little more to spend, then considering an ED80T is another valid option. It's another apochromatic refractor, which means that it's relatively easy to set up with minimal visual aberration. One of the reasons that I'd undoubtedly recommend this telescope is that for its quality, it's very lightweight. This makes it a good choice for anyone looking to travel with their telescope. If you live in the city like me, then when you're going stargazing, you'll want to venture outside of the city to avoid light pollution. A lightweight telescope makes this a little easier. The ED80T is actually perfectly made for astrophotography, as opposed to some other cheaper telescopes, which may not be suitable. The ED80T has a focal length of 480mm, which is pretty suitable for a telescope of this stature. While the focal length isn't the main thing you want to consider when buying a telescope, it's still worth taking into account. Overall, this is another good option if you're looking for an entry-level astrophotography telescope. At number 3, we have the Orion 10-inch Astrograph Reflector. In terms of entry-level telescopes, Orion are one of the better choices to opt for. If you don't want to opt for a refractor and you want something with a greater focal length, then you might want to consider going for a Newtonian reflector. The good thing about Newtonian telescopes is that they generally run a few hundred dollars cheaper than refracting telescopes. The general rule is that if you're trying to view things at a greater distance, but you're on a low budget, then you should look at getting a reflecting telescope. However, you might sacrifice some image clarity in doing this, which is why I personally prefer refracting telescopes. And although the 10-inch aperture sounds impressive and works well for viewing distant planets, you might find the image quality isn't as good as with an apochromatic refractor. This is true for most Newtonian reflectors, but the Orion Astrograph has been specifically designed for photography. One of the main issues with this telescope is although it works well, it's really heavy, as in 25 pounds heavy, which is a bit of a nightmare if you're looking for a portable telescope that you can easily transport with you to low light pollution areas. Overall, this wouldn't be my first choice for an astrophotography telescope, but if you're definitely looking for a Newtonian, this would be undoubtedly my choice. So that sums up our top telescopes for astrophotography of 2019. We hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like on the video, and if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Until next time, have a great day.